Nikki, it's Gary Vaynerchuk. You're on the Ask Gary Vee Show with Michael Ovitz.
Wow. Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
It's an honor.
What's your question?
Michael and Gary.
Thank you.
So I guess I should just ask my question.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
I'm assuming. basically, I just wanted to ask, with being with Creative Artist Agency, what's something that when you work with a lot of other people, kind of high profile, that you don't want them to do, that you're like, oh, this is a mistake they made. They could have had been my client, but yeah.
You mean something that you don't want them to do?
Like, what's a mistake that when you have artists who want to be your client, something that they do that prevents you from saying yes to them?
Oh, you mean the other way, where when you're at the top, like a CAA, what would a emerging actor, actress, director, athlete say that could actually turn off CAA from saying, you know what, you're not the right client for us? Is that the question?
Correct.
Interesting.
That's you know, I've never.
The answer's always yes. Yeah. We want as many clients as
normally,
possible.
Normally the answer is yes, so I've never thought about that.
You know what's funny? It's funny that both of you and I reacted that way. A lot of people talk about be thoughtful about what, you know, my team, very senior people, lots of great people. We have to be thoughtful about who we bring in. They need to be the right kind of client. I'm like, yes, yes, yes. You know, it's funny that we both reacted that way.
So
have you ever had a meeting where you were court? Let's go this way, because I'd love to hear it. A play on that question. Did you ever court somebody because you're like, oh my God, that would be a crown jewel, or that'd be a big get for the firm? And I know you went whale hunting. Was there ever, as you were whale hunting through the years, when you actually got closer to it, you said, oh shit, she or he is such a headache, or they have this vulnerability, or somebody in our stable has emerged as a direct competitor and we don't have the bandwidth. Was there ever, to her point, was there ever any of that?
Yeah, we had one situation which was really difficult for us, which is we, as you've already mentioned, we handled Sylvester Stallone, and he was very competitive with Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Mm.
And Arnold was somebody that I really wanted to represent.
Because yes.
He was he's the most terrific guy.
Yep.
He's really smart, and he really understood the paradigm of the action movie.
Yes.
I mean, better than anybody. If you look back at his body of work, it's
yes.
pretty amazing. And I went after Arnold and wanted him, and it got back to Sly, and he wasn't particularly happy about it.
And that's that.
That was that.
Is there a reason you're asking that question? Are you going through a path or anything, like you're trying to navigate?
Well, the reason why I ask is because I feel like, as someone who's in Los Angeles and is, you know, along with hundreds of thousands of other people, what is it? People always ask, oh, what should I do to get into the door? And so I was like, is there something that I shouldn't do to when I'm trying to get into the door? Because
that's a great question.
It seems like everybody has an answer for how to get into the door, but not like, hey, make sure you don't do this.
You know, I think short of anything illegal... I think anything short of illegal or immoral, you should do whatever you feel you have to do to move your career ahead. We were lucky. We went after talented people. And at the end of the day, talent wins out.
Always.
And I think it's when you're young, you have to look for breaks. You really have to look for breaks. And they may be social. They may be business.
Yep.
They may be because you've got an idea. Let's not forget, we spoke about Stallone. This guy wrote a script called Rocky.
And on spec.
On spec, on his own dime. And
sold his damn dog.
Everybody wanted to buy that script and move him out of it. And to his credit, he said, no me, no script. And
that's hard when you're hungry.
It's really hard. It
when
took
you're hungry.
A lot of guts to do that, because he was offered a lot of money for that script.
The thing that's different today than some of those years past for Sly or when you were at CAA is people can now go direct to consumer. You can now produce content and use the distribution of an Instagram or YouTube or a podcast to absolutely give you leverage to be courted in a very interesting way. In the way that you created packaging with leveraging to studios, the human can now create content to build leverage to have people bid for them.
Absolutely.
I mean, that's what happened to me, by the way. Real quick, my little quick CA story is I started a wine show on YouTube in 2006, and in July of 2007, after showing up on Conan on late night, because the producers reached out to me because they were watching it on YouTube, the next morning I had an email from Endeavor before the merger, William Morris, others, everybody ironically but CAA, then said on my show that I was going to Hollywood to find an agent. It was like this funny joke because I thought it was crazy. And then I got an email from some people that worked at CAA. They were having a fantasy football draft that day. And they said, why don't you come and hang out with us? I said yes, but they didn't say they were from CAA. They said, what are you doing here? I said, I'm going to see these Hollywood agents. They said, are you going to see CAA? I said, no, and they made it happen. And that's who I ended up signing with. That was all based on me producing a wine show in a store in Springfield, New Jersey. There was no moving to LA and waiting on tables and going to auditions. We have an incredible world we live in now where you can create the leverage for you on the back of the internet.
Different time, completely different. In our day, there were roughly 25 companies that controlled the complete gate.
Yep.
In other words, the barrier to entry
yep.
was severe. You had 7 studios, you had 4 networks, you had 5 publishing houses, you had 5 record companies, and probably, 10 companies in Europe that controlled everything that you would read, see, and hear. Our company had relationships with all these companies.
The end.
If you were a client, you got in the door. If you weren't a client,
you were out.
You had trouble getting in yep. the door. Today, this person that called in, if they could make something 3 minutes long using their iPhone or a small Sony camera, they could put it up, and if it went viral, good God, who
Kiki,
knows?
Do You Love Me, the dance? He's in Drake, Shiggy's in Drake's video 4 months later. One video on Instagram. It goes, it's just incredible time.
And it's the only song my 3-year-old grandson wants to hear.
I get it.